Check it out, right? I'm doing the last little touch-ups on the presentation to bring out the app, the website, and the product base. Sean Fonte, you know what I'm talking about, God Plus Problem, bringing all that out. This is what I've been doing for the last 3 years is working on it. I usually work on it in my truck. This is the third truck I had working on it in. This is a big boy Chevy, though. I had 2.4s, all of them was on 6s. One of them was on 2s, and I put it on 6s. But I've been studying in all my trucks, and I usually come somewhere by the water and work, you know what I'm saying? I usually got all my paperwork. I got my books, you know what I'm saying? I got my bag, you know? So what I'll be doing is, come and chill and relax, and I smoke something, chill, get all the way at peace with myself, be thankful with God for all the blessings He's given me, you know, and all the challenges and lessons that I've made it through. And I gotta say, I passed a lot of tests with God, you know what I'm saying? He gave me a lot of tests and I passed them, you know? So shit, I'm thankful for that. A lot of people don't know, but that's what I know, because I'm the one that went through it, you know what I'm saying? And I've been blessed, and I've been rewarded too. You know, like if you go to class and you get all A's, you know, you come home and your mom and dad, you got good parents, and they know you've been a good kid, they bless you. I'm like, son, you know what? You got all A's in your report card. You know? Psh, you got a little blessing for you. Same thing God did for me. I got all them A's, boom, 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 boom. You know, I failed a lot of classes, though, you know. I failed a lot of classes, so, but I kept coming back and I kept studying, you know what I'm saying? So now I done passed the classes, you know, and the test that He set for me, I'm getting rewarded. You know what I'm saying? So you can't be mad at me. You be like, damn, His Father goddamn blessed him. You know what I'm saying? He must have been doing good. Yeah, I was doing good. You know what I'm saying? So my Father blessed me. You got the same Father. He'll bless you too. He's watching you just like He's watching me. You know what I'm saying? So right now, I'm sitting in my truck, you know, smoking a blunt. I got to get rid of these ones, but I really don't smoke blacks. I'm letting y'all see, but I don't smoke blacks like that. But I'm just, you know, relaxing, doing me. I do whatever I want to do. But what I'm doing, I'm writing a movie called Only the Strong Survive. I'm writing that. I got the first 5-6 scenes already written, you know. I got another writer that's gonna be writing with me, Troy D. Y'all know him. Y'all see him on 1150 the channel, jamming like a jam box. Okay, so I'm doing that in my truck today, working on my presentation, going over stuff. And I got an archive, a box for archives, like a file or whatever, of my old thoughts, old raps, all this shit from like 15 to 20 years ago, you know what I'm saying? I even got letters from my mom that she wrote back in 2008, this month, on the 13th, you know, my family member wrote back in 2008 to help me get out of prison, you know? And I got those letters, man. I've seen them today and I was real thankful for that, you know what I'm saying? I really appreciate that my family was there for me, you know? And I got letters that say, you know, don't forget about certain people that was there for you when you was locked up. You know what I'm saying? And that was very touching. Letters that I got from myself that I got to reflect on and look at. Like, damn, man. You know, I was really thinking back then. And I always wanted to make sure I was real to the people that was real with me when I was down. You know what I'm saying? I never wanted to forget them people. My mom and Twyla was definitely number one. in my life when I was locked up. You know what I'm saying? That's 100%. I had other people there too, off and on, and some people rolled it out. You know what I'm saying? I appreciate them. You know what I'm saying? But I want to give a big shout out to Twyla and my mom. You know what I'm saying? I'm going to redo Twyla House too. You know what I'm saying? I've been doing it. You know what I'm saying? But anyway, that's what I'm doing right now. I'm sitting in my truck, going over some old raps and shit that I wrote, man, like 20 years ago, you know what I'm saying? Found them in my little archive. Them motherfuckers is hidden, though. Let me see, I got one I'm gonna spit for y'all, you know? It's just, shit, I just been finding, man. I'm just fucking with it and shit. Let me see which one I wanna find and spit for y'all, you know? Let me see. Let me see what this one say. Yeah, y'all, a couple of them. I'm just going to spit a little bit off a couple of them. The old heads say, the way we live, our lifestyle is pitiful because we pack pistols. Like, it's a ritual. Yeah, they say we are some sick individuals. Okay, old heads say we living like our lifestyle is pitiful because we pack pistols. Like, it's a ritual. Yeah, they say we some sick individuals. So I had to break it down real simple. I ain't never been saved. I was brought up on the block, pushing cocaine. I was trying to get paid, watching out for the raid on Tuesdays and Thursdays. Cause me and my niggas be posted up in a dope spot with more racks than a cave, with more rocks than a cave, more drugs than a rave. And a nigga don't want it, no beef with us because we'll come deep like a parade and ride the block like a wave in them Chevys with them gats up ready to spray, putting in work like a slave. True renegades is how I was raised. So when them guns get raised, motherfuckers get blazed. So ain't no use to being brave. That ain't gonna get you nothing but broke off and put in a grave. So you better off joining a religion and getting saved. Real, for real niggas somewhere, and go somewhere and pray. Cause we'll make a motherfucker death day today, okay? So if you don't want that, then relax. And I won't have to cock back the strap and start spitting and hitting like a quarterback, or get upset and start disrespecting motherfuckers set and leaving shit wet. I'm an OG vet, so just let me swerve and get high off life. Something like shit like that. The nigga was going in, though. You know what I'm saying? I got hella raps. You know what I'm talking about? So, that's what I'm doing today. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, man, when you got a belief in God, man, your whole life gonna change. Like, when you really get connected with God, go through so much ups and downs and shit. You know, people have their little first, they first little glimpse of pain and shit, then they be all scared and depressed and wanna kill themselves and shit. You know, but that's a part of life, though, baby. I was there too. You know what I'm saying? That's why I don't judge nobody that be going through shit. Cause motherfuckers don't know what a motherfucker been through. You know, I've been through a lot of hurt, through a lot of pain. So when you see me winning and smiling all the time and shining and shit, it's cause I done suffered a lot. You know, And I know suffering is really in your head, you know, but you got to be intuitive. You gotta search for advice. You can't be afraid to speak on it. You got to find somebody to listen to you. You got to listen to yourself, because sometimes you gotta talk to get that shit out when you be going through pain and shit. But it's always a greater side to it, because once you get connected with God and understand life, you be realizing that those just be lessons to correct yourself. You know, you might be doing something wrong, or, you know, because karma is a motherfucker. And you don't want certain shit, you don't want karma coming back on you unless it's all good karma. You know what I'm saying? And right now, I got hella good karma coming back on me. So he's just going to be seeing me get blessed. Boom, boom, boom. He always blessed. He always getting blessed. Nah, baby, because I've been through so much, I had to change the way I think. Your thoughts create your reality. But I couldn't understand that until I was digging into them books and reading and reading and reading and researching and going through stuff and trying to figure it out. You know what I'm saying? Constantly getting closer to God, because it's like you just reading the Bible. To me, the Bible is like preschool. You know what I'm saying? It's from motherfucking kindergarten to high school to college and shit. So if the Bible is preschool to me, that means you got to continue to search and continue to look for knowledge and continue to find ways to get closer to God. You know, you can't let that be your only channel and say, boom, that's all I'm believing. You know what I'm saying? It's got to be more to it. You know what I'm talking about? Got to be more to it. So, you know, you got to keep digging deep inside, baby. But it's there, you know. It says only 5 elements in the world. And the most important component is your thinking, the infinite, your imagination, you know. Your thinking power, your mind, your brain, you know. That's what creates every reality, you know. God is your imagination. You know what I'm saying? You connected, selected, and blessed it right now at this moment. I'm trying to tell you. So, I'm just giving y'all a little glimpse on how I be rocking, how I be doing shit, and how I be staying focused, you know what I'm saying, and believing in something that is invisible, that can't be seen, you know what I'm saying, but being so passionate and having it really in my heart to never leave. Like, you know, I've been doing this for over 3 years, every day, and now this is the final, like, steps of it, you know what I'm saying. I'm excited. It's exciting, it's scary, in a sense. You know what I'm saying? Because it's something you never did. And it's like, you know, you get butterflies and shit. You know what I'm saying? But all my butterflies is flying together, though. So, you know what I'm saying? It's different, you know? And I know my challenges and shit, what I got to face in the future and stuff. So, you know, I'm excited about that. I'm thrilled to be a part of that and to be who I am. Like, you know, I'm excited about me. You know what I'm saying? Like, every day, I'm excited about who I am. Like, I'm excited that I'm here. I'm excited that I'm me. I'm excited I get to be with me all the time. I fucking love that shit. I ain't gonna lie to you. I love it. Fucking love it. I fucking love it, baby. I motherfucking love it. I ain't gonna lie to you. Yeah. So, yeah, man. I've been believing, man, for a long time. You know what I'm talking about? And, I've been believing so much. Shit, I thought I was crazy for a minute. I was like, damn. Shit, I'm believing it's gotta be crazy. I gotta be losing my motherfucking mind. What I think God's gonna do for me, man, that shit gotta be impossible. I'm like, nope. That shit, man, what the fuck am I thinking? But I kept thinking. And then shit, it just became my reality. You know what I'm saying? And shit, it is what it is now. You know, it's my reality. And I love it because it was my best thinking. It was my highest thinking, it's my greatest thinking. You know, I was thinking great about myself. Extraordinary great about myself. Extraordinary great about myself. Every day I'm Mary Lewis Fresh too. Yeah, I've been thinking extraordinary about myself. So yeah, I'm gonna be great. Big, huge, humongous Joseph. Yeah, that's me. Yeah, that's one of my nicknames, that's one of my handles. But that's what they call me, humongous. Yeah, so yeah, my motherfucking goals and my motherfucking reach is humongous, baby. Yeah. It is, without a quiz. Yeah. For real. Yeah, I'm about my grandmother business too and my mama business. So, you know, and everywhere I go, I always get a picture of my granny in the truck with me, you know what I'm saying? Right there, like Tony Blair. You know? So I'm rocking like a cut off stem knocker. I don't know. There's always cakes out here. Hey, I had to change the subject, but man, hey, where you go is beautiful cakes. I love cakes. That's my thing. Hey, judge me. I wouldn't give a fuck. I don't give a fuck about that shit. Yeah. That's what I'm into, though, sweet thing. Y'all get to, I'm get to be me every day. You get to see it. I ain't afraid to show you who I am. I love me, G. Yeah, so I'm writing a movie, Only the Strong Survive. You know what I'm saying? My life is a little documentary. It's just like a little documentary. You know what I'm saying? You get to see the real motherfucking Joseph Anthony the Brand, the man with the plan. I'm gonna do it with both hands. And right now, my thumb is kind of fucked up. It ain't stopped nothing. Got a whole nother hand. Yeah. I'm gonna do it with both hands, baby. Both of them. Shout out to wife, I ain't heard, too. That's my other mom. Yeah. I got three. I got them all tatted on me, too. Lily Mae Harden, Wyvonne Harden, and Mary Lewis Harden. You know what I'm talking about? Mary and Joseph against the world, baby. I shall inherit the earth, man. I just look like this. Y'all thought I was going to be somebody else, huh? Thought I was going to be somebody perfect? You thought I was going to be somebody perfect. You thought I was going to be somebody so perfect that you was going to have to be perfect. But you are perfect. If you being your true self, you perfect, baby. That's how God made you. Yeah, you just got to wake up and be yourself. And don't be nobody else. You know what I'm talking about? Somebody in you right now. You better bring them out. It's somebody new. The real you. Yeah, so 11:50 the channel, man. God plus power. You know, y'all stay tuned to that, man. Just the beginning, man. You know, I had to introduce who I was, what I was doing. Me, LouStylez, T-Top Taye, having it our way each and every day. You know what I'm saying? We stayed down, man. Put God first. That's only how we came up. For real. That's only how we came up. Only way. The only way. Wasn't luck, baby. Wasn't luck, baby. Wasn't luck, baby. If you want to get rich, all you got to do is do it. Do it. That's it. That's the key to getting rich. Do it. You got to want to do it, then do it. You wanted to get a job, didn't you? You got it. Whatever you want, you're going to get it. You want that small shit. That's why you got small shit right now. You ain't want nothing else. Nothing at all. You didn't want anything else. So don't be mad at me because I wanted something big and I came with it. Came back with it. Went to get it and came back with it. So I'm out. Till next time, man. I'll holler at y'all. 11:50 the channel. Joseph Anthony the Brand. Man with the plan. I'm going to do it with both hands. Baby.
Paperwork
party.
Never did no paperwork, nigga. Paperwork party. Paperwork party. Paperwork party. I'm good on the paperwork. Good. Wake up out of lean, come and go straight to work. There. Nigga, crack the seal for me, let me taste it first. Taste. Nigga, blow that shit. I never seen a money truck chase a hearse. Shit fucked up for me, it snatch a purse. I was just talking to the broker, trying to snatch a verse. Cuz told me stop rapping, but the rapping worked. He was trying to put me on game, how the vacuum work. I don't wanna party, that paper fell on my mind, I retarded. I ain't have a clue, it'll be this when it started. The price of a blue raise up when you further. Nigga need to drink water, we ain't got my peace water. I be on this sleepwalking. So many blues on me, I feel like seawalking. When Siri get directions, I imagine re-talking. Nigga, I'm trying to keep ballin'. Dog walk bitches, I should put a leash on them. I ain't need liquor, put a half a pee on them. No limit to this shit, I might master pee on them. Fuck them.